Thanks for checking out this unboxing video. So this is for a box of dread. Now I know it's been a while since I've posted one of these, not because I'm behind on anything, but because box of dread is behind. I know they've had some shipping type issues. I forget. I don't know if they're using UP. I think they might be using UPS. It's either USPS or UPS. I don't know. But they've had some issues there, but they've also had some issues in-house because it's really just one guy, John Condit, doing it. And I think he gets help here and there, it seems like, but I don't think he's getting enough help, unfortunately. So, you know. I canceled this, though, because of all the issues that they're having. I've become very unsure if things are going to hold together and, you know, how bad things are going to get. Easy for them to get behind again. I mean, they're still currently behind. And this box is actually a combination of the December and the January, which we're getting. I mean, I just got it yesterday on February 10th. So, yeah, December and January together. So, I mean, I applaud them for getting caught up and just putting the two boxes together, but at the same time, for like doing unboxing videos, this is actually terrible for me because I'd rather have a December and a January to put up two separate videos. Instead, I'm not even necessarily going to know what's what. It's just all one big box for 2 months. So the other thing is they've not done a good job of making customers happy. Their response times to emails, people asking for subscriptions to be canceled, because people who signed up early enough with the company had to get subscriptions canceled through email. And they've been very, very late on that. I had to send 3 emails and make 2 posts on their Facebook page before they actually got back to me and canceled my subscription. So customer service is bad. I understand because it's understaffing, but honestly, like, if people want their subscription canceled or if people are asking where their boxes are, you got to try and make that a priority. Like, the thing is, it's your company and you got to figure something out. You have to. Otherwise, you are going to go under. I mean, people understand that you're understaffed to a point, but at the end of the day, it's still a company and people are paying for the product and they will leave. Like, I'm choosing to leave because of the uncertainty. I like what they put in the boxes. I like the company, what they stand for, and they're nice people. But for me, I just, you know, I don't want to deal with it anymore. It's more of a headache than anything. The other thing is they just sent an email. Before people got this box, they sent an email saying, hey, guess what? In 2018, we're increasing the price from $20 to $25, which is fine if they were already caught up on everything and they let a little time pass so people are happy again and just like, okay, everything's settled, everything's good. I feel like then you can go ahead and say, hey, we have to increase it. You know, granted, they did say, you know, if you've already been signed up, you can sign up for an additional 12 months. And if you do that, it'll lock you into the $20 rate for those 12 months. That is good. But I'm just saying, sending out an email saying, hey, we're increasing prices, when they're still really behind, some people haven't gotten the last 3 boxes, the last 4 boxes, like, it's a mess. You cannot send an email saying, hey, we're increasing prices, and you're not even getting a good service at the moment. People are gonna get out, and I had already asked to cancel at that point, so when I saw that email, I was even more happy that I asked to cancel. So, I mean, I wish luck to John Condit and the Box of Dread folks. I really do. And, you know, maybe in the future if things get better, I might come back. But for now, I'm done. I don't want to deal with it. It's your problem, not my problem. And you haven't handled it very well. So, sorry. But let's check out this one. And I think, oh, no, I didn't pay for the February one. So this might actually be the last unboxing. I don't even know. That's the thing. I'm so confused now because they're so behind that, like, I don't know what's up and what's down pretty much. All right. Oh, so they have their own box still. The box within a box. Dread Central. Or, I'm sorry. Box of Dread, but yes, it's a subsidiary of Dread Central, just so people know. All right. I'm hoping for some good stuff. I'm going to be really pissed if it's not decent. All right. a poster. I think there's two posters in there, I felt. I'm eh on the posters. The other thing, like I always say, they roll them with the artwork on the outside. I prefer to be rolled with artwork on the inside because then it's easier to put it on a wall. Because not everyone wants to buy frames to frame these things. So this is for Lucio Fulci's Zombie. And it looks like it's actually a comic. The artwork is really good. I mean, it looks good. Nothing wrong with how this looks. I mean, look at this. I'm trying not to get too much glare, but as you can see, a little closer up. It's cool. The syringe needles there are very indicative of Nightmare on Elm Street. Freddy Krueger. But that's cool. It looks good. Let's get this other one out of the way. Oh my god. Is this for the same fucking thing? Come on, man. It is. Lucio Fulci Zombie. Both these are from Ibon Press. Yes, it is like an actual comic book cover. There you go. It's just a different cover of this zombie comic book. This is like a, I guess it's a zombie gorilla? Ape zombie, it says on it. I mean, so these are two separate months, okay? And it's the same product. It's just a different cover. I feel like that comic is such a specific thing that you can't include two of those. You have to vary it up. Like, get a different poster. Because if people don't like it, then they're just like, oh, I didn't like the first one, I don't like the second one, what are you doing? Oh, this is a... Yeah, so one of the boxes, I think it was the January box, was curated by Adam Green, the guy who did Hatchet, and he has a new movie, Victor Crowley, coming out, so this is kind of just a write-up about him. So, I'm not going to read it because it's going to spoil some of this stuff, but that's what it is. What is this? There's some sort of like... Oh, DVD. Oh, okay. Hatchet 3. Uncut and unrated. That, I mean, it's appropriate if this is, you know, one curated by Adam Green. So Hatchet 3. That's fine. I'm not actually, full disclosure, not really a fan of these movies. I'm just not a fan. I don't really like the Hatchet movies. I'm not going to read the synopsis of this. I think a lot of people who are into horror are pretty familiar with the Hatchet series. I have a buddy who loves it. Just loves it, so maybe I'll just give this to him. But I mean, that's fine. You know, it's not my thing, but that's fine to have in there. Next thing, Hatchet 2. Okay. Once again, you're doing two things. I mean, this is a big win though for people who are like into this. Although if they're really into it, they probably already own it. I don't know. Is Hatchet 1 in here, then? It doesn't seem like there is, most likely. Which, why would you just give people 2 and 3 and not give them 1 and complete it? I don't know. This is weird. Alright, got a Twilight Zone figure, and it's a limited edition one, which is pretty cool. So, Twilight Zone, the ballerina from episode 79, 5 characters in search of an exit was the name of that episode. This is number 1,203 out of 1,400. And as you can see, the ballerina. See, this is cool. Like, getting these toys. These are cool. You see Twilight Zone. And then there's all, like, the different ones on the back that you can get. I'm sorry, the lighting's not, like, the best. There's no natural lighting today, and I usually kind of rely at least a little bit on some natural lighting. As you can see. So that's probably the first item I really like in this. That's bad. All right. Next thing. I don't even know what this. Oh, it's another one. Okay. So I got a second Twilight Zone figure. Okay. Everything is done in twos in this. Okay. So I got also from episode 79, 5 characters in search of an exit, the hobo. And this is number 1,173 out of 1,400. So there is the hobo. Alright. Once again, that's fine. Next item is The Monster Project, available on Amazon Prime, and Vilmark Asylum, available on Amazon Prime. There's no, like, codes or anything for the movies, which this is just a promo thing. But for this one, the Vilmark Asylum, they did email people and say, here's a code to go watch it. So that's cool. I wish they would have done it for this one, The Monster Project, because that looks significantly more interesting for me. Because, like I said, I'm not into, like, haunting stuff, and that's what Vilmark Asylum looks like. Okay, it feels like maybe we have, like, a graphic novel, which is cool. Okay, The Twilight Zone, graphic novel. Volume 3. What? Why would you give a Volume 3? The Way Back. Okay, now I'm hoping I don't have to have read the first two volumes. I mean, this is a fine, this is a good idea. Like, it's a good idea. But give people Volume 1. Don't throw people into the middle of a series. Like, now, basically what you're doing right now is being like, if you actually are interested in this, you have to go out on your own, spend more money to get Volumes 1 and 2. Just give us Volume 1. And then if we're interested, we will go buy the other volumes. Not going so well. Next one is a piece of artwork. What is this? And it's signed by someone. I guess it's who did it? Rusconi? The print looks bad. It's not very good. I guess it's supposed to be like an interpretation of Regan from The Exorcist. You can see it's signed up the side. There's no, like, authentication or, like, indicating who did it or... I mean... And the actual print itself is kind of... looks kind of muddled. Like, when you get really close, it looks kind of, like, pixelated, actually. I don't know if you can really see it there, but... this is poor quality. And, it's not very good. Alright, next. Oh, this is going to be hard to get out. It's kind of jammed in the bottom. Alright. And then the box is empty, so we'll get rid of it. Delirium Magazine, which is cool. Like, I'm down to read some horror magazines. Rue Morgue is my favorite. It's anyone who's ever read it knows why. It's phenomenal. I haven't actually... they gave us one of these Delirium comics in one of their other boxes, and I haven't read it yet, but I do mean to. I will. It's cool. I like the idea of this. I mean, dollar value wise, it's the boxes are fine. I think, like, yeah, pretty much fine dollar value wise. Actual products, I mean, I'm not happy with it, especially when this is, like, two put together. Like, magazine, fine. The comic volume, fine if it's a number one. Don't give me a volume three, because it just makes no sense. This art print is such a random thing, and it doesn't even look good. I don't know. The Twilight Zone characters are cool. I like this. This is a great idea. To give people two, though, just seems a little odd. But they are limited edition, so, I mean, it's kind of cool for that reason. So that's decent. The Hatchet movies, good for people who have not, do not own these and like them a lot. I think it's kind of weird to give two of these. And if Adam Green is curating it, why didn't he have something more interesting? You know, like... it just seems random. It seems weird to give you two and three. Once again, where's the first one? Why would you just give two and three? Why are you... I mean, it's weird. It's fucking weird to me. That, you know, promo thing. I didn't really mean to throw it. It just happened. And then the two posters, which we talked about. I'm like, why would you do two of the same thing? It's... I don't... not too happy with it. makes me glad I got out, honestly. Yeah. Sorry, like I said, I mean, Box of Dread, like, legitimately, I wish you guys luck. You have done some good things in the past that I quite enjoyed. There probably are some people who are pretty psyched about this, like, liked all the stuff in there. I'm just saying, for me, I don't like it, and kind of glad I'm done with it. But you guys got to fix your customer service response time, and big misstep on sending out that increase in price before you got everything in order. Because people are still missing a lot of boxes, and man, just makes me kind of like sad for them that they're going through all that stuff and they couldn't like pull it together in a good way. But oh well, like I said, good luck, John Condit. Like, you seem like a good dude. I'm sorry all this is going this way, but good luck to you, man. But until next time, I'm still doing the regular BAM boxes at the moment and the BAM horror. And then I've got a new one coming that's food related. It's actually called Snacku, and it's like small company made, like family owned company made, like snack items. So it's not like candy stuff. It's a little different from Japan. So anyway, thank you everyone for checking this video out, and until next time, keep it brutal.